Shalom, shalom, Israel. I want to do a quick video. First, I want to give all honor and praise to our Elohim, the Most High, Yahawah, Bahashem, Yahawah Shai, our Adonai. And I'm going to get straight to the point. I want to do a study on the scripture of Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. You know, us as a nation, the Israelite nation, we got to remember to break scriptures down and to gain understanding. You know, the scripture saying, all thy getting, get understanding. And this is for the ladies, strictly for the ladies, but it's also for the men of our nation as well, because I got to say it. I'm sorry. I got to say it. These camps are teaching false doctrine about Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. And scripture, it basically says, the woman shall not wear that which pertains to a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are an abomination unto Adonai Yahuwah. So, you know, I had a family member that said, you know, sis, I take the scriptures for what they say. Yeah, we supposed to do that at the same time. Why y'all think they have a Strong's concordance? Why you think they have definitions of things? There's a reason why they have the lexicon definition. There's a reason why scriptures need a breakdown. You know what I'm saying? So I'm coming to y'all humbly, and I want to share this study with y'all. I've been fasting today. You know what I'm saying? Requested. You know what I'm saying? He's like, let's do it. You know, so I've been fasting today. So I'm cleansed from a lot of things that I don't need circulating in my mind. We're supposed to renew our minds every day. So our praises to the Most High for fasting and prayer. Because if you just fasting, what's the point? You know, we got to fast and pray and study to show ourselves approved every day. So Deuteronomy chapter 22, and I'm reading from the King James Version. I just read it to y'all. So Deuteronomy 22, verse 5 says, the woman shall not wear that which pertain unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all they do so are an abomination unto Adonai Yahuwah. Right? So let's look at the word pertain. Okay? If you go to the etymology definition of pertain, the etymology definition of pertain means to belong to, relate, to have reference to. You know, when something belongs to somebody, to be applicable. You know what I'm saying? It's a possession of someone else's. It's a physical condition, you know. So when the Most High said a woman shall not wear which pertains to a man, I'm about to break it down for y'all. That basically means, say, okay, my husband, right? I can't wear my husband's sweatpants because I want to be comfortable, because those are men's sweatpants. I can't just put on his jeans because I'm gaining weight, because his jeans bigger than mine, and I just decide I want to put on his jeans. I can't do that. I can't go shop in the men's section and buy men's pants and buy men's t-shirts and anything that pertains to a man. So the etymology definition of pertains in Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5 mean belonging to, possession of. You know, there's a reason why they have a men's section and a women's section. For example, if you go and buy pants at a TJ Maxx or something like that, Marshall's, Walmart, you shop in a women's section, right? A real woman shops in a women's section that wants to wear women's pants. If you shop in a women's section, those pants pertain to a woman. They don't pertain to a man. So it's vice versa. If a man puts on what pertains to a woman, like homosexuals, the real flamboyant homosexuals, they wear bras, they wear skirts, they wear dresses, they wear everything that pertains to us. They shop in a woman's section. That's what he means as far as it is an abomination. Basically, cross-dressing. You can't be cross-dressing like that. He didn't say not to put on pants. So the scriptures talk about modestly, and there are women in this truth. And, you know, brothers and sisters and these elders in these camps, they say dressing modestly and they talk about not wearing pants, right? But you got on a dress and a skirt and it's tight fitted on your body. You can see every curve, every part of your body, but you're not dressing modestly, but you have on a dress. Because you think this scripture, Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5, is specifically saying not to wear pants or jeans. Y'all make it make sense. You know what I'm saying? So in Exodus chapter 28, verse 42, let's go to it. This is talking about the breeches, how the men wear the breeches back in the day. So Exodus chapter 28, verse 42, and it reads as follows. And thou shalt make them linen breeches to cover their nakedness from the loins, even unto the thighs that they shall reach. So in the scriptures, when it talks about breeches, I think it's like two other scriptures in the Bible that talks about how the men wore the breeches were worn to cover their loins, meaning their posterior. So the breeches in the Bible was worn just up to the knees. So when the scripture talks about a woman shouldn't put on what pertains to a man, or a man shouldn't put on what pertains to a woman, if you look at the definition of breeches, breeches is basically the etymology. They're short trousers and it's just below the knees. Not only that, y'all, this is in the old times in the Bibles when the men wore the breeches. It was under their skirt-like garments. Make it make sense. It was under their skirt-like garments. That's why they had to wear breeches to protect their loins, their posterior. Now that breeches, it represents, it resembles a pantyhose. So it's like a stretchy grip on your body. You know what I'm saying? It's close fit. You know, so y'all get where I'm going with this? And men wore cassocks. They wore skirt-like robes. Make it make sense. 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 27. It says, and as Samuel turned about to go away, he laid hold upon the skirt of his mantle, and it rent. Okay, and I'm going to go further. 1 Samuel chapter 24, verse 5. It says it again, but I'm going to read 1 Samuel 15, 27 again. And Samuel turned about to go away, he laid hold upon the skirt of his mantle, and it rent. Now, go down to 1 Samuel chapter 24, verse 5. 1 Samuel 24, verse 5 reads as follows. And it came to pass afterwards that David's heart smote him because he had cut off Saul's skirt. Now, like I said, the definition of skirt, if you look at the lexicon concordance, it's talking about garment, the edge, the border. But it's the same number, the passage that comes up when it talks about the man's skirt and how the kings wore the skirts in the Bible. It's a garment. It's the border of the shirt. It's the edge, the extremity. Okay? And it's the same number for a skirt. It's H3671. It says the same definition. Let's go to Psalms 133, verse 2. So Psalms 133, verse 2 says, it is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard. Even Aaron's beard that went down to the skirts of his garment. That went down to the skirts of his garment. Now, I'm going to run through these passages real quick. Y'all heard it? Did you see it? Don't just hear it. I need you to see it. You know? Let's go to Haggai chapter 2, verse 12. Haggai chapter 2, verse 12. If one bear holy flesh in the skirts of his garment, Salakia, and with his skirt do touch bread, and you know it goes on, but I'm going to stop right there because y'all get my point where what I'm making in this scripture. I'm going to read it again. Haggai chapter 2, verse 12. If one bear holy flesh in the skirt of his garment, and with his skirt do touch bread, da 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 da, meaning the scripture, the passage keeps going. But that's what the scriptures say. So I'm going to repeat myself again because I need this to get, you know, us as a nation, we're supposed to edify each other. in the body of Christ, in the Hamashiach. You know, that's important. You know, a lot of times me and my husband, we keep our mouth closed. And, you know, my husband brought this to my attention. And I have convocations with my dad, my rabbi, my mom, you know what I'm saying? And we edify each other. But we knew this a while ago. I'm just bringing it out to y'all because the Ruach, he I got to be obedient to the Most High, you know? So this is what I'm called to do. I'm being a vessel and I'm allowing him to use me. And that's just what it is. You know, it's not me. It's all him, you know? So I once believed that for a long time. I'm like, yo, but I ain't believe it. The thing is, I didn't believe it. I was like, what are they talking about? How are we not going to be able to wear pants? You know, I have on pants now. I have on a dress. But the split come up to the thigh. So I have on pants, but they're stretchy pants. You know, I wear loose fitted pants. I wear the dressy type professional pants, but it's in modest apparel. I present myself very modestly in what I wear and how I talk, my speech, everything. You know, so this is for the ladies. I don't know, you know, a lot of y'all following camps and they're teaching that we cannot wear pants. And that's not what the Most High is talking about. So there's one more scripture I want to, go to, Zechariah chapter 8, verse 23. The Most High told me to bring this out to y'all. I have to be obedient to him. It's really not about what you wear. As long as you're following the laws and statutes and commandments and you're not wearing what pertains to a man. If a woman don't wear what pertains to a man, which are men's clothing, and a man don't wear what pertains to a woman, which is woman's clothing, because that's what the scripture breakdown is of this passage. So let's go to Zechariah chapter 8, verse 23. Zechariah 8 verse 23 says, "Thus saith Adonai of hosts, in those days it shall come to pass that 10 men shall take hold of all languages of the nations, even shall take hold of the skirt of him that is a Jew, saying, we will go with you, for we have heard that Yahuwah is with you." That's another scripture. You know what I'm saying? So it has to make sense, is my point I'm making. This was in my spirit. I had to share it with y'all. I'm fasting today, you know, and I'm thankful that the Most High brought this to me to share with y'all. You know, I had to. So the breakdown of the breeches for the men. Not only that, if you look in the old times, how the men wore the breeches is for the posterior, is for their loins. They had to wear breeches because, come on, you can't just be hanging out like that. The genitals had to be covered with the breeches. So that's another point I need to make. Us as women, we wear pantyhose and tights and stretchy, you know what I'm saying? That's what the men wore, believe it or not. If you see what horse riding, how the woman and the men wear the horse riding pants that stop at the knees, some come down to the ankles, but they're breeches. They're considered breeches. And the scripture says, like I read in, where is that? Like I read in Exodus 28:42, the breeches is their short trousers and they're just below the knee, the definition of that. It's basically garments for the legs. There are also scriptures that say, that passage that talks about, I'm not sure, so I'm not going to quote it. There's a passage that talks about how, it, you know, the Most High says, gird up your loins. When he said, when he was talking about the men girding up their loins, they had on like skirt like garments. So they had to take the front part of their skirt like garment and take the other part and they had to tie them to gird up their loins. A lot of y'all didn't even know the definition of that. To protect their private area. You know what I'm saying? So it got to make sense, y'all. The Most High brought that to me. I came to y'all very humbly. I want to edify the body of the Hamashiach. So all praises to the Most High for this study. I hope that it was edifying for y'all. I don't want to be long. I did want to be 20 minutes max. So, you know, shalom. Shalom.